First of all, brand standards and industry association standards, in my opinion, are hopelessly out of date. The technology is changing rapidly with the life cycle of mobile phones and smartphones and tablets. I think the brand standards need to be more reflective. More importantly as well, it's the owners of hotels who fund the technology, it's not the operators, and sometimes greater effort needs to be put into that. I mean, for example, now the examples we could talk about is there a need for a two-line phone when nobody uses the phone? Or is there a need for a bathroom phone when I don't know if anyone even uses the phone in the bathroom? Or even some people still saying there's a need for a fax in a room. I can't remember the last time I used a fax. But anyway, so I think no, greater emphasis. And I think the brand standards and the ratings need to be more reflective of the technology that's in the marketplace today. It should be a free amenity because that's what the customer wants. The question is, how does a hotel continue to fund the infrastructure and the pipe when it's continuing to increase? Because we know that if something is free, then people abuse it and use it incessantly. So my answer to the question is, yes, it should be free for a basic service, but then we should be offering tiered bandwidth. We as an industry have done a very poor job to understand the needs of our customers, and we should be saying to a customer or a guest, if you want to download a movie or view a YouTube video, we suggest this is the plan you should be on, and maybe you should be charged $3 or $4 or $5. But we don't do that, so everyone elects to go on free. It's a poor service, and then there's no winners at all, because the hotel thinks it's doing the right thing in the end. So if it came to a choice between good internet and I had to pay as opposed to free Wi-Fi and it's poor, I'll pay every time. I think you're going to see a proliferation. The TV as we know it, I guess, is going to change. I think my sense is that with more and more people moving to internet-based TV, you'll see probably more like a monitor than a TV. I think you're going to see, for example, people voice communications, like, you know, the stuff that Microsoft's doing and Wii's doing, where you'll actually talk to the removal of remote controls, and maybe you'll talk to the monitor or the TV or whatever the device in the room, and that will then drive the forward. I think you're going to see the need for the traditional desk to eliminate, because more and more people now, we know, using iPads and tablets, sit on the bed or in a comfortable chair. So there's going to be some fundamental design changes in the room. Look, trying to predict 8 years forward is a very dangerous thing. If someone had asked me that question in 2004, I think I would be, probably a bit off the mark. And it would be a fascinating exercise to look back at what people said in 2004 and see how many people were really accurate. Well, I think I touched that in the last question. My sense is that, is what we've had to find now is that, look, our industry's now, it's about the consumerization of technology. Bring your own device, bring your own content, and more people are comfortable. You only look at the number of people who sit on planes or who are watching movies on their iPads or their tablets, or even my son will watch videos and live sport on his smartphone. So the question then is, the question was asked this morning, how long am I in a room? I have people, friends of mine who don't even watch the TV. My sense is I don't think within 8 years, in 2020, I don't think there will be a TV as we know it today in the room at all. Maybe in the really luxurious hotels, but I think across the board, because it's an expensive piece of, it's an expensive device which we don't use a lot of, and it takes up a fair bit of space. So I think the reality today is I think you're going to see the TV as we know it today almost disappear, and maybe more and more people at the moment are showing a greater interest in using their own devices with their own content. And we, as I said, the other question is, I say, how long do you spend in a guest room today? These days now on meetings and stuff, I'm out for dinner, I'm on the run, I'm here, I'm in the lobby doing quick emails and stuff. So the reality is, do I have that much time to watch that beautiful real estate, that lovely big film that I may have watched in the past? So I don't think the TV in its current form is going to be completely different in 8 years' time.